as to why we will not stop making the hats. This time it does not begin with the beaver, instead only halfway up the mountain, where the sheep we keep each year come through winter enough to answer us, enough for us to shear, deft before the coming storm, to take away from the body what it did not know it grew, and then astonished each spring to feel the quickening of the lamb, the heft of sudden weight crossing one more patch of snow. All with an eye out for the cougar or some such animal of which the DNA is no longer what it might have been. The coyote now as part dog, part wolf, already commonplace. We have come to know the truth as no longer true. The old ways do not work against the new. How to reconcile the bear as she comes down to what we now call ours, and how to prepare for the unforeseen as we throw each sheep handily on their back to begin at the belly, fleece to shear, to wash and pick, to card, to bale, to weigh, to the depot where all will be spun, dyed into the wool we want, knowing it can be done again and again without much death. For the sheep, she rises, shakes herself back into where she was before, grass, lamb, watches until we have pulled away. And as we head back down the mountain, and in something like ability or capacity, the condition of being human or female or both, we want to knit this out into dawnlight, into a long stream of making sense, into where we will go next, into skeins of design and colors of what blood can mean, pinks such as rose or carmine, wanton or nearly red, timid or raw, healing or newly born, scarlet, blaze, bloom, or shell, or blush, like the small fingers of awakening child, each stitch to repeat, purl, and dispatch, to get this done and into that which we can call sustainable, so those from behind can choose from the many hues, likewise to walk forward with covered or uncovered heads.